Hello students, in the previous video I had explained half of the poem and then rest of the poem I will explain in this video. Now let's begin the poem. No, the root has to be pulled out of the anchoring earth. It is to be roped, tied and pulled out, snapped out or pulled out entirely. Hereby no, the poet means that the only hacking and simple jab, only hacking and chopping won't be able to destroy or kill a tree. And so from the next lines, the poet tells us the actions which are needed to kill the tree. So what we need to do if we want to kill a tree, the root has to be pulled out. Roots, we know that the strength of a tree lies in its roots. So if we want to kill a tree, destroy a tree, so what we need to do, we need to pull out the root. And from where we need to pull out the roots? From the anchoring earth. Here the poet says that the most important part of a tree is its root, and it is rooted in the soil, in the earth, and the earth plays the role of an anchor for a tree. Because the tree gets support and stability from the earth, and the strength of a tree lies in its roots. So if we want to destroy a tree, kill a tree, so what we need to pull the roots out of this of the anchoring earth. And after separating the roots from the earth, we should tie it with a rope and pull it out of the soil entirely or completely. So in the opinion of the poet, if we want to kill a tree, in order to destroy a tree, we should hit the most important part of the tree, that is its roots. We should try to uproot the tree from the earth. We should try to separate the roots and the earth. In this way we can kill a tree. And in the next line the poet says that out from the earth came, and the strength of the tree exposed. The source, white and wet, the most sensitive, hidden for years inside the earth. Now the poet talks about the next step. What is the next step? What does the poet say here? He says that when we pull out the roots from the cave-like earth, now the strength of the tree is exposed, because the strength of a tree lies in the roots, and which are white and wet, and which are the most sensitive part of a tree, and they were hidden inside the earth for so many years, and now when we have pulled it out from the earth, they are out of the cave, they are out of the earth, and they are exposed now. Let's read further. Then the matter of scorching and choking in sun and air, browning, hardening, twisting, withering, and then it is done. Now the poet is telling about the next step. Now the next process is to scorch and choke the uprooted trees, means to dry it up in the sun, and when it is kept in the sun, it gradually gets brown, it gradually gets hard, twisted, and finally it withers and dries up in the contact of sun and air. And the poet says then it is done. It is done means the task of killing the tree, the task of killing a tree is done now, it's finished now. So in this way we can kill the tree. And in this way, the tree will finally die. This is the end of the poem, and let's have some questions. Read the extract given below and answer the questions that follow. It takes much time to kill a tree. Not a simple jab of the knife will do it. It has grown slowly, consuming the earth, rising out of it, feeding upon its crust, absorbing years of sunlight, air, water, and out of its leprous hide sprouting leaves. Now the questions are, the first question is, who is the poet of the above lines? The second question is, why is it very difficult to kill trees? The third one is, what does the poet compare the bark of the tree with? The last one is find the name of a tool from the passage that is used to cut things. And now students, you have to answer these questions and practice at your home and write the answers of these questions in your PC copy.